Hey folks, it's Brian, and I'm doing another project for my junky truck. Alright, so that's the ignition switch I'm going to put in it. And I've cut down this piece of stainless steel, got over at Metal Supermarket in Southwest Houston, and made a template out of cardboard. It's going to fit where the fuel switch used to go, so it's going to sit right in there like that. And there it goes. That looks nice-ish. So the next step is to put this hole in it. So I'm going to use my mill for this. So let me get the milling machine set up. jacked up and I'm gonna need to make another one. But let's see. First, let's get all the shrapnel off. Yeah, that's not exactly the round hole I had in mind. So, how bad is it? Oh, it's still salvageable. A more complicated setup by using the vise, but that's just not—it's not gonna fly. So we're gonna use something else. Let's see. But first, we need to flatten it again. need to make like some machinist amps. That'll work. So many things I need to make in this place. What do we got here? Nuts. I think we'll pull this over here. We'll go this way. So it's there. Would be tall enough. So we're going to grab it by that end. There's probably different ways to do this. This is just what I'm using because it's what I have handy, and I think I can put a lot of downward pressure on this piece and it'll stay still. All right, so we need a little more height here. Literally, a little more height. Don't know if I'm gonna have enough tool stick out to get in there. We'll find out. that doesn't move. Alright, we are 100% retracted. Yep, bet you I got to stick out for it now. don't know why I didn't just do this in the beginning and just use a 3/4 inch end mill. Would have been a lot easier. Here. We'll just set that back in there. That is much faster. It's one close. There are other ways to have done this, and maybe I should have done that at the beginning, but yeah, whatever. Hey, what do you know? It works. Now. All right, let's unrig the other one. Thank you. this is a 5/16 bit. Question, hang on. So the question is, will a 1/4-20 bolt fit comfortably through there or not? I think it needs to be a 1/4 inch, but I'm going to do a test hole back here and we'll find out. Thank you. Okay. How far we're gonna get with that, we'll see.
All right, let me go turn the phase converter on. Thank you.
Okay, so let me get this all put away and we'll see what we got. Alright, there we go. Not very pretty, but it will do the job just fine. So let's see what that looks like. Yep, that will do just fine. That's about as close to perfect as you're going to get. We'll put this other piece on. It probably is perfect. There we go. So, now let's get it mounted. All right, so we got this, and doesn't look very fancy, but it is fancy. Yeah, it'll work just fine. Remember, junky truck, not fancy truck. Let me go find some nuts. Okay, so we're gonna keep it shiny and we'll use these. Get deleted. There's not a nice way to do that. Alright, I'll come back to that in a minute. In the meantime, let's get these tightened down. These just need to be snugged. They're more than capable of holding this little plate on here. It's just going to look good. And make it unpleasant if someone ever wants to take the ignition switch off, which probably would be me. All right, so we got one more problem back here to deal with. Find a little something to cut that. Well, I finally found something that cordless grinder is good at. grinding plastic. I was afraid it might actually have been too much for it, because, yeah, it's a piece of shit grinder. Powerless. There we go. So now we got all four of them. That looks pretty good. Yeah, that's a mess. Alright, so how's this gonna look? Just like that. Get that back in there. And then this will go in like this. Alright, let's go put it together. But first, let's see what size we need. We'll take that with us. Anyway, let's get it together. Alright, lighting probably stinks. So here's our battery terminal. And it's going to get two connections because I was worried about the gauge of wire that I have. Why is this so damned hard? Where'd that go? It's like 100 in hell with that out today. Ouch, I am getting shocked. Damn it. How am I getting shocked? Then we have the ignition side. I thought I had a metal splinter in my hand there because it was like buzzing me. It's like, what the fuck? That's probably start, so I'm going to gamble that that's start, because the other one's accessory, which we're not going to use. Least of the things I'm worried about on this vehicle. Alright, be right back. So, let's just see what happens. Comes to life. Yeah. It's almost acting like a normal vehicle again. Other than wanting to shock me. All right. I don't trust it. Sweet, it runs. Let me give it a wrench so I can tighten that. All right, for my next magic trick, let's see if it moves under its own power. This video. Thanks for watching.